A beer from Porterhouse out of Ireland here. So this is Ireland's largest genuine Irish brewery, 100% Irish. It's their Oyster Stout. Yeah! All right, and it's 5.2% alcohol by volume. We got pale malt, roasted barley, black malt, and flaked barley. For hops, we got Galena, Nugget, and East Kent Goldings. So yeah. Warming up a little bit, got out of the fridge. You know, do you want to drink your Irish stouts real cold or not so real cold? I guess it's personal preference. I like this one a little bit warm, a little bit warmer than, you know, right out of the fridge for damn sure, you know. Yeah, we're going to warm it up a little bit. We got that super awesome fucking pull tab here they got there. Check that out. Now, let's pour this beer. You know what I'm saying? Okay, all right, so a few of these already. This is an awesome session beer for me. I'm really liking this. I've also had their red ale, big fan of that. Put a link down in the description if you want to check out that review of that beer. So yeah, 5.2 out of Dublin, so we got that Dublin hard water, right? Nice teal label here. 3D imprint on the oyster. Pretty cool. Nice subtle aroma, yet there is kind of rich. There's a lot of things going on. Heads of sides to kind of a low carb frothy scum. Now, okay, so stout. There's a little bit of redness, a little bit of transparency, so you can see a little bit through the bottom there, right? Alright, we're gonna, like, this is a really cool beer. I'm just gonna, just bear with me. So, the malts are pale malt, roasted barley, black malt. So I guess in the roasted barley, it's got a little bit of residual, like, caramelized sugar. Same thing, we left the crystal malt a bit because I'm definitely getting a little bit of nice maltiness out of this beer to kind of round it out, fill it out. Slight bit of caramelized residual. Wouldn't call it a sweet beer, but it kind of sweetens up the front of it a bit. You're getting the char, burnt, like, what's the other one here? The black malt and the roasted barley. You're getting kind of like the black soot vibe off the front of it. Also tying in with like a heavy calcium vibe in the finish. So it's a bit chalky in the finish. Really cool beer. As are the oysters, yes, yes. This one's a little bit cold. As it warms up, you get a lot more oyster out of it, so. Now, I threw the box away, and I can't remember if it said it had the oyster shells in it or not, but that, if they did, that might explain why it's so extra chalky, even beyond the Dublin water kind of thing. A very chalky calcium basic mouthfeel to the finish of the beer for sure. This one is not getting as quite as much residual head, which does add, you got kind of a low carb, light, frothy, creamy, small head to it, but it really like helps out the mouthfeel and that really richens it up. Adds to the whole drinking experience. As for that roasted barley, it's a heavy, nice, like almost like I would almost call it like damn near crystal. It's really full. Adding some sugars, some smoothness to the beer, filling it out. Oh, just giving it, it's a malty stout. It's not as dry as you think it is, or you would assume. It's definitely got some malt presence there to round it out. There's definitely oyster. You can taste the oyster. It's not overbearing. I'd say slightly more malt forward than oyster forward. And hops, maybe just a little bit. You got the three varieties of hops. But they're under there, but it kind of gives you that nice kind of mossy kind of peaty type hop flavor underneath it all. Yeah, it's really the biggest surprise for me was that it's got a little bit of malt to it, kind of bigger and warmer than you would expect. But yet the finish is cold and dry, like you would expect out of an Irish stout. Nice. At times you're picking out the black barley and the soot. At times you're picking out the maltiness. At times you're picking out the oysters. Sometimes you're picking out the calcium. Sometimes you're picking out those earthy hops. Not real overpowering flavors. It's a 5.2% oyster stout. It's not an American barley wine or something. But definitely flavor is here. A great session beer. I could drink a limitless quantity of this beer. I mean, I could just really overdo it on this stuff. This is really awesome. So I'll show the cap here. Now we got kind of like a rubber fin in there. And so this kind of, you know, was once together. And the fin sealed it all. And then when you just kind of break that tin apart, or I don't know if it's like lightly pressed together or whatever, but it's built to come apart at least only halfway. And then the pre-cuts or whatever stop. And then, of course, this is just a very thin tin. So this kind of, you know, just pops off as you pull because it's just a very light, thin tin cap. Really cool cap that they've invented there. Oh, these guys, I think this is something that they do across the pond or whatever to, like, I don't know, as an alternative to fucking the caps. Regular caps. It's a cool cap. I don't see them on any domestic beers in the Americas, so. The only other time I've used a cap like this is on their red ale, so. I don't know if it's just in Ireland or if it's all over Europe or where, I don't know. It's a cool beer cap, though. Yeah, the stout grains add to the mouthfeel. The burnt barley definitely affecting the mouthfeel. Calcium affecting the mouthfeel. Even the oyster, the barley being a little bit heavier, like residual, caramelized, affecting the mouthfeel. It's an extravaganza of fucking awesomeness. This is a really cool beer. I'm really liking it for the style. It's awesome. The more you drink, the better it gets. So yeah, pick up the whole 4-pack. Absolutely. Really liking this. Really like the red ale from them. They got other beers. If I see them, I will be picking them up. There we go. Fucking nice. A lot of flavor there. Really enjoying this. I'm going to have to 9 3/4 an easy out of 11. Yeah, but very sessionable, very awesome drinking experience. Highly recommend this beer. And I'm looking forward to trying more oyster stouts because this is the first one I've had, and I'm really blown away. I love oysters, and this is really fucking awesome. So 9 3/4 out of 11, no problem. I think I hit everything. All these really cool textures, mouthfeels, and flavors, and their super cool beer cap. And I'm flabbergasted. You gotta try this beer. If you can get this, you gotta seek out the... I would recommend seeking out the Porterhouse, ignoring all the other beers, just to try this Oyster Stout, even though it's just a stout, 5.2% stout. It's a really nice, not over-the-top drinking experience, but definitely, definitely the shiznit. Beer Zucker, and I'm out. Yeah!